Hi, I'm Randy Vance. I'm on Lake Conway today with the folks at Regal, and I don't usually wear a hat in these videos, but this is Regal's 50th anniversary, and my hat's off to them for a half century and three generations of excellent boat building. This is the LX6, the largest of a new series of boats. It's outboard powered, it's got great technology on board, and features I want to walk you through right now. Now, from a performance standpoint, the LX series is not just a stern drive with an outboard slapped on. This boat has been designed to accept outboard power and optimize it. Thanks to the fast track hull, power steering, and electronic throttle and shift, you've got the optimum in control, speed, and performance. One of the things we notice right off the bat is how well the fast track hull cornered and stuck to the turns, no matter how sharp we cranked them. Now, many outboards that you see have a limited space on the transom platform, and Regal has optimized that by creating this sliding seat platform. It comes forward 14 inches to give you a complete beam-to-beam walkway on your platform. You've still got a transom walkthrough, and if you're cruising, slide it back 14 inches and you've got maximum space in your cockpit. The seat backs themselves can be inclined all the way forward to give you a completely flat sun pad, or just inclined part way to give you an aft-facing lounge. With the seat backs flipped forward, you can access the ample storage underneath. With the seat platform pushed all the way forward, you've got these cutouts here in the corner that allows people to sit in the corners without bumping knees. That adds two more seats to the boat. Now, as you can see, this cockpit is enormous. Regal has found an extra 6 inches in this interior space when compared to similar boats of the same beam. Now, to make this cockpit space even more enjoyable, Regal has added this power hardtop. You can tilt the top up and lower the entire module down to cover the cockpit for low bridges, and it gives you a great place to duck out of the weather should you encounter a storm. Now, here's a nice convertible feature. Flip this back and you've got an aft-facing lounge. Take a look at the upholstery. It's sculpted, straight double stitching. I like the ribbing. And this is a custom crafted grab handle that you'll find on top of each seat. Flip it back and you have easy access to the head compartment. Below, you'll find a porcelain electric head, a stainless steel sink, a portal for light and ventilation. Now, there's some subtle design features that I like in the forward seating area. One is you've got this little cutout area. That gives you more leg room when you've got a large group up here. Another thing I like is the way this combing bolster gives you a great place to lean back and face the cockpit. If you're sitting facing forward, you've got armrests, and we like the easy access to the storage compartment under the driver's console behind this seat. Naturally, there's plenty of storage under the seating, but one other thing you should notice are the pods under the combings. They're upholstered for a rich look. They're stainless steel cup holders, grab handles, and you've got USB charging ports for mobile phones. There's a pair of stereo speakers as well to bring the sound forward. Now, this boat is equipped with a windlass and a bow thruster. Now, with all that heavy-duty electrical equipment on board, Regal has designed in a robust power system to manage it. There are three batteries on board and a voltage-sensing relay to make sure your alternator on your motor charges the battery that needs it the most first. It'll mean that you never run a dead battery and you can always start your boat at the end of the day. Now, the helm station brings another electrical object that I really like. The seat slides fore and aft at the touch of a button. The seat back can flip forward, and that gives you an aft-facing lounge when you're on the hook. Another ergonomic feature I like is the armrest built into the combing. It makes sure that the throttle is easy to grip and the boat is easy to drive all day long. Now, the helm station is beautifully designed. I like the fact that it's upholstered to complement the rest of the boat. Both the bow thruster and the trim tabs are easy to reach. And you've got a tilt wheel to adjust the helm to your comfort level. I like the fact that it's equipped with dual Garmin displays. Not only do they give you complete engine output information, you've also got a complete navigation suite and, through either display, full control of your Fusion audio system. Now, the LX6 is the largest and most fully featured of this new series from Regal. If you need a smaller boat, maybe don't need the head compartment, take a look at the LX4. It still gives you that same transom seating configuration that we like. Also, if you're looking for a boat that you want a trailer behind your car, take a look at the LX2. It has a completely level deck from the cockpit to the transom platform. All three have the same great Yamaha outboard performance and Regal styling. I'm Randy Vance for Boating Magazine, and this is Regal's 50th anniversary celebration.